tells some fun tales of the Brothers Grimm. So the learners have been working very hard this semester on this production, and the past couple of performances, they had a performance last night, they had a matinee performance this morning, and they are starting to really step into their characters. It's super fun to see, so I hope you all enjoy it very much. We have in the production booth have just been every day, been cheering them on so much, more and more. But I will say, you all as an audience have some shoes to fill, because desert, ocean, tundra, and rainforest this morning were just hooping, hollering, and clapping, and those kids love the performance. So I hope you enjoy it as much. Feel free to join in, hoop, holler, clap, giggle. It's fun, it's meant to be fun, and I hope you enjoy it. So thank you.
Leading the witness, sustained.
Of your friend, then. In your previous testimony, you stated that we
I just couldn't imagine why even a bloodthirsty wolf would want to bother a sweet old lady such as yourself.
Objection, Your Honor.
It's Your Majesty.
Excuse me?
I am your king. You should address me as Your Majesty.
But you're also the judge.
That's right. I'm the king and the judge. King judge. Why is that so hard for you to understand?
My apologies. Objection, Your Majesty.
On what grounds?
On the grounds that the witness's testimony is prejudicial.
How so?
By adding extraneous details such as calling the wolf bloodthirsty, it's quite enough for you to simply say that he ate a frozen wolf.
Overruled.
My Your Honor, Your Majesty, you're such a wise and honorable king and judge. Surely your infinite wisdom can see that my client is not getting a fair shake here.
I don't know about that.
Isn't that a new set of robes, Your Majesty?
Why, yes, they are!
I thought so. They need to look 10 years younger if I do say so myself. Maybe it's just your frozen complexion.
You can't change the opponent's trial by. Turn it on the charm. Prince Charm.
Oh, I love
this. Stop right there. I know exactly what I'm doing. It's that infinite wisdom that I'm seeing right through guys like you. If you want to be out of the detective court, give your remarks to the case and not to my wardrobe.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Do you have any further questions for the witness, Grin?
No further questions.
Does the defense have any questions for the witness?
None, Your Majesty. You may step down.
Thank you, Your Majesty. I saw that huntsman.
Saw what? I'm just a huntsman doing a civic duty by sharing testimony.
He's trying to frame me. They all are. I have no idea what you're talking about. King Judge, the defendant, he's harassing me.
It's you who's harassing me, huntsman. You've had it out for me ever since I told the evil queen that the heart you brought back to her was really from a wild boar.
That is quite out by you, wolf. Prince Charming, get your clients under control. I'll be forced to have removed from my courtroom.
Good luck, Wolfie.
Prosecution card, too.
The prosecution calls Little Red Bryce to the stand.
Well, that's just it.
I hope you don't mind, Your Majesty, but if I were a few keys for the big test level.
How bold of you?
May it pass or not before I give my testimony? Everyone here looks a little tired and cranky. And there's nothing better than a crankiness than a sweet treat.
By all means.
One for you.
Thank you, my dear.
One for you. And none for you, because you're a big old meanie.
Is she serious?
Objection! Defendants can't object. Only their lawyers can.
Really?
Huh? I have no idea.
I already told you, it was all a big misunderstanding. Your granddaughter did more than give me a swat. She used that basket to pummel me senseless. And I tried to run away, but as I was running, I tripped and fell into a puddle, ruining my brand new suit. That's when I saw your nightgown hanging on the line. I was only going to borrow it for a few days until I could get my suit laundered.
But what about the testimony that says you
ate Granny whole? Nothing but lies. Lies, I tell you.
Now, keep it going for the host who's always reflecting the look.
gosh.
I don't know why you bother asking a bunch of silly questions. Your audience can clearly see I'm the most beautiful woman here.
You are quite a striking woman, stepmother.
Okay, well, you know why? I am so sick of your act.
Oh, look at me. I'm so white. Aren't we pretty and sweet?
What?
Are the contestants ready?
I am magic here. Thank you for asking.
Then let's begin, hands on butlers. For our first question, tell us about a time where you helped someone, even though you didn't have to. Snow White?
Well, I was walking through the forest when I came upon this family of butlers.
Here we go.
They looked so hungry and cold and right away that I had to help them. So I took the warm shawl I was wearing, making a little nest, and I gave it in the basket of berries I collected.
Aww, what a kind and beautiful story that was.
I guess I have a soft spot for cute furry creatures.
Evil Queen? It doesn't have to be a story about cute little furry creatures.
Oh, how about that time I decided not to kill my husband for disobeying my orders?
No, I don't think that's what we're looking for.
How about the time we gave a fair maiden a beautiful lace for her bodice?
Maybe.
Actually, that maiden was me, and you stitched the bodice lace so tightly that I nearly passed out and died.
I think that point goes to Snow White. For our next question, tell us about the best gift you have ever given. Snow White?
I'd have to say that the greatest gift that I've ever given is the gift of a story. When I first moved into the Seven Dwarfs cottage, I soon realized that none of them have ever read a book. So that first night, I gathered everyone around the fireplace and told them the most wonderful stories of princesses and dragons in far lands.
There is no gift quite like that of a story which entertains and engages the imagination. Evil Queen?
So, one day I was walking through the forest when I came across this tiny little cottage. And this cottage lived a very lovely maiden. In fact, this maiden was so lovely that I was compelled to give her a gift. Beautiful comb for her hair.
A poison comb.
What was that, Snow White?
The comb? It was poison. The minute it touched my head, I fell unconscious. If the dwarves hadn't found me in time, I would have surely died.
Hey, you just said it had to be an awful gift, okay? I put a lot of thought in
that. Alright, moving on. For our final question, tell us about a time where you convinced someone that they could trust you. Evil Queen. Imagine that!
To prove that I could be trusted and that my apples were safe, I took a bite of the apple myself. When the maiden saw that I was perfectly fine, she accepted the apple and tried it for herself.
And?
So what?
And the apple was poisoned, and I passed out and nearly died again.
I think it's clear that there's only one possible winner on tonight's show. Snow White, you are the fairest one of all! But you must remember, true beauty comes from within. Good night, folks!
Why do I bother?
Roger Rabbit, Ginger?
No, that's actually the right one, okay?
I always get those two mixed up.
Common mistake. But as you can see, the running man is unique because the dancer looks like she's winning, even though she's getting plenty. Needless to say, I'm ready to die for the dinner next time.
What dance is that princess doing, Ginger?
Oh, that would be the first one. They probably want to find some tiny skeleton to show. But where comes the higher stuff? I'm back to the problem to find the rescue to me.
What about that princess? Oh, that's a killer.
Bunions for you, bunions.
So what if they are? Those princesses must really love dancing.
Indeed, sources inside the palace tell us that these princesses are dancing so much, their children are living in their
own. Ouch, that must be painful.
Worried they're going to develop corns on their feet, Cornelia?
Hey, that's a real problem for a lot of people.
Tell me about it, my feet are killing me. Oh no, one of the princesses collapsed.
Don't worry about her. She'll be fine.
I'm not fine, Ginger. If you don't just stop dancing, it'll be over. Please let it be over.
Well, it looks like the dancing season is near to finish. But I'll be sure to give our viewers an update a little later in the hour.
Just watching those princesses makes me tired.
Speaking of tired, our own field reporter, Harry, is on site now with a very exciting update on Overwatch. Harry, are you there?
And if the clock tolls in the 100 years Sleeping Beauty's rest, something tells me Briar Rose's question. for true love still continues. Back to you, Cornelia.
Thank you.